Hey guys, so for today's video, I am going to be doing episode 16 of my Create This Book series. In this video, I am going to be doing three pages, and I really liked how all three of these pages turned out. So be sure to stick around till the end of this video to see what I create. Let's get started with the first prompt. The first prompt is create a family. Draw, attach, or assemble an image of a family. So the way I interpreted this was to draw like any form of a family and just like draw all of them together. I decided to draw four koala bears all just hugging each other and sitting together. I started off with the base sketch, which was just getting the main shapes together and sketching out the main idea of how all of these koalas were going to look together and their positioning, etc. This looks very messy at first, but if you trust the process, everything turns out fine in the end. As you can see, I am drawing this with mechanical pencil. I used to only draw in like normal HB pencil, but I've recently started really liking to draw in mechanical pencil. I just feel like you can get very precise with what you're doing and you don't need to sharpen the pencil, which is great because I feel like it makes the process of drawing much faster. After a while of finally getting all the base shapes and things, I had outlined this and also started coloring. I outlined this with a gel pen that had a very fine needle tip. The line art style that I went for was very neat and clean and simple because the coloring is actually where everything comes to life and all the detail work is done. As you can see, I am coloring this with my Uhuhu markers. There's no reason in particular. I just really like blending with my Uhuhu markers. I feel like it gives off a great effect and I can get a lot of shading done with it as well. I also colored the grass in this very bright, vivid green just to add a pop of color and also make things look colorful. Fun fact, it was actually really hard to decide on what I wanted to do for this page. I had so many ideas in my head for it. I ended up doing koalas because I had found this really cute photo on Pinterest. I will leave the link down in the description. It was so adorable and I really wanted to draw this photo in my own style and I thought it would really suit this prompt as well. Lastly, I just added in some finishing touch-ups and also painted the background in blue to represent the sky. Here is the end result of this page. Overall, I like how this page turned out. My favorite part about it is the fact that all these koalas are together and they look so cute. I don't think I've ever drawn koalas before, let alone in like a sitting position and with all of them together like this. It was a pretty difficult and challenging way to draw them in, but I think I achieved it and I really like it. The next prompt is create an array of media. Draw one object over and over using a different medium each time. The object I chose to draw over and over was toucans. I chose toucans because they are very colorful, especially rainbow toucans because their beaks are like multicolor with so many different bright, vivid shades and hues. This would be perfect for this page because I'm really trying to show how different colors look with different mediums and how I use each of them in my own style. If you guys have seen a couple more of my videos and like have an idea of my art style and how my art looks, then you would know that color is a big part of my drawings and my illustrations, which is why I decided to choose such a colorful thing to draw for this page so I could really show my coloring skills and my art style in all four of these mediums. As you guys saw, the first medium I used was Uhuhu markers, which are alcohol-based brush markers. At the moment, I'd say that brush markers and alcohol-based markers are my favorite medium. I really like how they apply, how smooth they are, how they feel when you're drawing, the blending, the bright colors. Colored pencils aren't my favorite medium to use, but I still really like how precise you can get with them and how realistic you can draw. For the next toucan, I colored it in with watercolor, so this time I'm actually painting. I absolutely love watercolor. It's like my strength when it comes to painting. At the moment, it's probably my second favorite medium, but it's constantly changing whether I like watercolor more or alcohol-based markers more. It's just so satisfying to paint with watercolor, the way it applies on paper and just the strokes you get with it. It's just so satisfying. I struggled so much with getting a good color for the beak of this toucan. In my reference photo, the color of the beak was quite bright, but also slightly muted at the same time. I know that makes no sense, and it didn't when I was mixing this either. So the color would look too brown, and then it looked too yellow, and then it looked too bright, like a traffic cone. So honestly, it was really a struggle with that, and it took me a while to finally get a good color. Finally, I added a bit of shading to this toucan, and the parts that were white in the photo and in the actual toucan, I didn't just keep them the white of the paper because that just makes things look incomplete. So I added in a very light gray to make it look part of the toucan and add a finished look. The last toucan on this page, I did a section of it in water-based markers so that I was still following the prompt of doing every object in a different medium, but I didn't have enough water-based markers to do the entire toucan in that same medium, so I ended up doing the rest of the toucan in alcohol markers once again. At last, I just painted in the background with blue watercolor so that it looked like all of these toucans were on branches in the sky. Here is the end result of this page. This definitely has to be my favorite page for this episode because I love all the bright colors and how each toucan has its own unique characteristics. My favorite out of the four definitely has to be the one made with the Uhuhu markers because I really like all of the bright colors in it. The second favorite of mine has to be the one done in watercolor. I really like the effect the position it's sitting in gives. I don't know, just something about it. I think it's the details on the feathers also that I really like. Which one do you guys like the most? The final prompt that I'm doing for this episode is create textures. Fill this page with a variety of different textures. If you don't know what texture is in art, it is an element of art that is used to show how an object appears or feels. For this page, I decided to draw three sea turtles. I chose to draw sea turtles for this page because there were so many places that I could add this effect onto. I used various different textures for things like their shell and their fins, etc. This sea turtle in particular, I really liked how it came out, the shape and things, it was just all really nice. I don't think that I've drawn sea turtles in my Create This book so far, so it was a fun experience. As you can see, I am adding texture right now to show the roughness of this area of the turtle. It was now time to color this in using my Uhuhu markers. I used to say that line art was my favorite part when it came to the process of drawing something, but now I actually think that coloring is my favorite part. This is because I feel like coloring is really stress-free and it brings my drawings to life and also adds a lot of character and charm to my art. Now I was adding shading to add some depth to my coloring. I also colored in the fins in this beige color at first, but as you will see soon, I actually changed that to more of a military green because I just felt like that went well with the rest of the turtle. The fins in the original photo that I was referencing were actually beige, but I felt like it really made no sense to color in the fins beige when I had already colored in the part that wasn't the shell in green. So I decided to just change the fins colors to green as well to make it all go together. I moved on to the next turtle, which is actually the largest out of all of the turtles in this page. I drew this one from a top view. I actually drew all of these turtles at different angles just to make things more interesting. I colored this in a very similar way in comparison to the first turtle that I had colored in. They look like it could be the same turtle from different angles, but honestly, I don't know. That's up to your interpretation. Finally, I did the last turtle, which was from this really interesting angle. It's not exactly a top view, but it's not exactly a front view. It's kind of in the middle, which also makes it give off this 3D effect. The coloring that I did for the shell was a lot simpler for this turtle in comparison to the other two. I just didn't feel the need this time to do that much shading on the shell because it already gave off this 3D effect by the line art and the sketching anyway. I finished off the shading and coloring, and here is the end result of this page. I like how this page turned out. I really love the underwater team and the sea turtles. Sea turtles actually happen to be my favorite underwater creature, so it was really fun making this, and the end result is also really nice to look at for me because I like sea turtles so much. That's all for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it and liked the artwork I made in it. If so, be sure to give this video a big thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. I will see you next Saturday at 6 p.m. CET, so be sure to be there. Goodbye!